Good morning, students.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning. Good morning to all. Is this finished, sir? So, what the last problem we have done? I think, seventh one, no? Someone asked a few questions, no? So you can raise your doubts right now. Some questions, few people have sent to me the question numbers. Yeah, so people, you can ask, you can raise the question number. If you have a doubts, we can try to solve that. So seventh is completed, no? So then today we'll finish that coefficient of expansion of the solids. Then we can go for liquids, then after that expansion of gases we'll see. 11th question, see that 11th question. The diameter of the metal ring is D and coefficient of linear expansion is alpha. If the temperature of the ring is increased by 1 degree, the circumference of the ring will increases by. That's the question they have asked. Okay, so circumference means initially, for example, this is a ring. This is the ring of radius, say R1. What is an initial length of the ring means? The length of the ring is nothing but its circumference. Then I can write L1 is equals to 2 pi R1. This is at what temperature? At theta 1 degree temperature. Similarly, if the temperature is increasing, means let the distance between the two, any two particles of the ring has to increase, means the radius of the ring will be definitely changed. Let it be, this is R2, this is at theta 2 degree temperature, and L2, that's equals to, I can write 2 pi R2. So then from the coefficient of linear expansion, what can I write? Alpha equals to delta L by L of delta theta. So then from this delta L, that's equals to L alpha into delta theta. Here delta L means what can I write? Here I'm writing L2 minus L1, that's equals to L1 alpha of delta theta. L2 minus L1 means, what is an L2 minus L1? 2 pi R2 minus 2 pi R1 means directly we can write 2 pi of R2 minus R1, that's equals to 2 pi R1 alpha of delta theta. This 2 pi gets cancelled. R2 can be written as what? Radius, that's equals to d2 by 2 minus d1 by 2, that's equals to d1 by 2 alpha of delta theta. If you take a 2 is common and cancel, means d2 minus d1 is equals to d1 alpha of delta theta. What is d2 minus d1 stands for? Change in diameter.
Excuse
diameter
me, sir.
Equals to what we can.
Sir, can you just summarize this again, sir? I just joined now. So because of internet problem.
Wait. So radius R is equals to D by 2, right? So then here also D2 minus D1 by 2, directly I can write. That's equals to D1 by 2 alpha delta theta. This 2 gets cancelled. Anyway, 2 by will not be there. delta d is equals to d1 alpha into delta theta. So then I can write delta d is equals to what is an initial diameter? Let it be d alpha value they have given. Na? What is that? Let it be alpha. Na? Alpha rise in temperature means 1 degree. So therefore, change in diameter delta d that is equals to d alpha. So this is about the question. Na? What they have given first, they have given a certain ring is there. A ring has a diameter, some diameter say d is the diameter of the ring. Okay, so diameter is nothing but capital D. They are asked that what is the change in diameter of the ring when the temperature is increased by 1 degree. So for example, at theta 1 degree, I have taken a ring whose radius is R1. Then what is total length of the ring? I will consider total length will be its circumference, then L1 equal to 2 pi R1. Okay, L1 is equals to 2 pi R1. Similarly, if the temperature is increased, it means the distance between the two atoms, any two atoms on the ring has to be increased. The distance between the two atoms is increased, it means automatically the length of the ring, that is nothing but circumference, will be increased. The new circumference at theta 2 degree is equals to 2 pi R2. And alpha value, they have given that the fractional change in length per degree raise of temperature, that is called alpha. So then delta L equal to this. Delta L stands for what? L2 minus L1. L1 alpha, with proper calculation, I got this. R2 means radius equal half of the diameter, based on that R2 equal to D2 by 2 minus D1 by 2. 2 is LCM here, 2 gets cancelled on either side. Then D2 minus D1 stands for delta D. Delta D stands for change in diameter. That's equals to this. Initial diameter is D, they have given that substituted. Temperature difference is in the problem itself. They have told that temperature is raised by 1 degree. Then D alpha into 1, that's equal to delta D equal D alpha. What is this delta D stands for means? Change in diameter. Got it?
Sir, yesterday's question doubt, sir.
Ask the question number.
Sir, question number 4, sir. Sir, exams, sir, not books.
Exams, sir.
Yes, sir.
Read the question then.
Sir, temperature of a substance increases by 27 degrees Celsius on the Kelvin scale. This increase is equal to?
Equal to 27 degree on Celsius scale.
Sir, they given 2.46 Kelvin.
That's
yes,
wrong.
Sir. 2.46 Kelvin.
Yes, sir.
Sir, given.
So many questions, sir. Not only one.
Sir, still there, sir.
Sir, many questions. Answers are given wrong, sir.
Yes, sir. We have checked.
So 5 to 6 questions.
Okay, once I will speak with the paper setter, okay?
So today you make change, sir.
Huh?
So today you will make changes of these answer keys.
There, once I will speak with the paper setter and key will be again, it will be corrected, okay? Na?
Sir, once you check, sir,
once we'll ask the question paper and we will correct the key, okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, paper set, once we will sit with the paper setter and we'll see that what are the correct options, then we can finalize the key, no problem, okay? After that, once again, if it is updated also, re-revised result will be updated in the groups. Okay. Yeah. So 11th is completed. Then after that, so in the case that above case area of the ring is increased by, you can write area means initial area is equal to what? Initial area is equals to pi. R1 square, final area is equals to pi have to screen. Instead of alpha, you should take beta. Beta is nothing but delta A by A of delta theta. Then you will get the answer similar to that. You try that problem. Students understand that problem. So 11th, 12th is continuation of 11th. What they have asked, the same data, what is the change in area they have given that. The change in area means the same thing. Initial area is pi r1 square. Final area of this one is pi r2 square. Here alpha how we have taken. Beta you can take. So beta can be written as 2 alpha also. Answer they have given in alpha. No? Beta equal to 2 alpha. That's equals to delta A by A into delta theta. Based on that you can calculate delta A. Okay. So that is about this thing. So similarly, some 15th, see that the question number 15th after that. Okay, 15th. Okay, so 13th, 14th is similar to this problem only. So 15th, see that question number 15th. Two rods have their initial lengths in the ratio of 2:3. Coefficient of linear expansions 3:2. When both are heated from 0 to 100 degrees centigrade, their expansions will be. Let me write this data first on the board, then we can discuss that.
Sir, 11th one's answer in answer, there is pi d alpha.
Which one? 11th one is?
Sir, in answer.
Okay, we have calculated change in diameter. No, circumference is nothing but what? The circumference of the ring will increase as by circumference is.
Sir, Sir, you find a delta D, but they ask you to find delta 2 pi D. Sir, they ask you change in circumference, sir, not change in diameter. So we have to write 2 pi no, sir.
So diameter, circumference, diameter, what is the relation? Circumference I can say S is equals to 2 pi r, or I can write, what can I write? S is equals to pi into d only, no? Pi into d. So this is the circumference. So then circumference, then I can write S1 is equals to pi into D1 and S2 that's equals to pi into D2. What is the change in circumference then? Change is nothing but S2 minus S1, that implies pi D2 minus pi D1, so that is equals to pi of D2 minus D1. So that implies pi of d2 minus d1 means change in diameter delta d. So that implies pi into d delta d value we got d alpha. No? That's why that is a pi d alpha. I didn't write the question properly. I thought it was the change in diameter. Okay. So till that we have done, that is correct. Continuation you can write this. That is nothing wrong in that. That is correct. Continuation you can write. Clear, students, this is a So make it fast and almost it is 9:25. We need to finish this solids. So next 15th one, see that question number 15th after this. Okay.
Sir, wait a minute, sir.
Question number 15th. Let me write this data. So what are the question numbers you got wrong in our last question numbers, please, students?
Sir, 4, 5, 12, 14, 18.
4, 5, 12,
14, 18. Anything sir, 5 changed, sir.
5 changed, eh? Okay, these 5 questions only, no? Or anything else also? Any other questions? Only these 5 questions of students. So write the 15th one. So what they have given first? They have given that the ratio of lengths L1 upon L2 equal to 2:3, coefficient of linear expansion is 3:2. Both the rods are heated from 0 to 100 degrees centigrade, then what is the ratio of their elongations? Delta L1 upon delta L2 is equal to how much that is? So as you know that the delta L that is equal to L alpha into delta theta. So from this what can I write? Delta L1 that is equals to L1 alpha 1 into delta theta 1. Okay, so nothing but change in temperature first rod. Similarly, delta L2 is equals to L2 alpha 2 into delta theta 2. Then I can write delta L1 upon delta L2 that is equals to L1 by L2 half. So here alpha 1 divided by alpha 2 into delta theta of 1 divided by delta theta of 2. This will be cancelled because both the rods are heated to same temperature. So that implies L1 upon L2 means 2 by 3 into alpha 1 by alpha 2 means 3 by 2. So then this gets cancelled. Finally, delta L1 upon delta L2 that's equals to 1. So then I can write it is 1:1. That is the options. So just they have given that and they have asked this using this formula we have calculated. So 16th also we'll see that is a bit different model. So copy it, students.
Just a second, sir. Done.
Atma?
Written, sir.
Yeah. So next, the 16th one, have a look on it, 16th one. So what they have given, this is similar to this, but a bit different. What is that bit different? Let us see. The two rods of same material and length. So same material in the sense, the coefficient of linear expansions are same because as they are made up of the same material and length are also same, they have given the radii in the ratio. So let me write this. Radii, they have given that. So they have given that radii R1 by R2 is equals to R1 by R2 equals radii.
Sir, which question, sir?
16th one. Okay, R1 by R2 equals to 1. So the rods of same material in the sense alpha 1 is equals to alpha 2, comma rho 1 is equals to rho 2. What is this rho 1, rho 2 stands for? Densities, alpha 1 and alpha 2 stands for coefficient of linear expansions. As both the materials are made up of the same material, both the rods, that's why the coefficient of linear expansions will be same and the densities are also same. And in the problem, they have told that lengths are also same. So therefore, L1 is equals to L2. What they have given means, if the same amount of the heat is applied, the ratio of their expansions, okay, so the ratio of their expansions, delta L1 is by delta L2 is equals to how much? When the same amount of the heat is applied, here understand this problem, same amount of the heat but not heated to same temperature difference, same amount of the heat is applied means dq heat supplied to the first rod is equals to heat supplied to the second rod. So then heat supplied means only temperature of the rods are raising, there is no change in state of the matter. That's why I can write m1 s1 delta theta 1, that's equals to m2 s2 delta theta 2. As both the rods made up of the same material means the specific heats also same. Okay, mass can be written as what? Mass is equal to density into volume. Density into volume means I can write area of cross section into length delta theta 1, that's equals to m2 can be written as, again mass can be written as density into volume. Density into volume means again I can write a2 into l2 into delta theta 2. So this l1 l2 gets cancelled because lengths are same. And densities rho 1, rho 2 also gets cancelled. This area can be written as pi r square. No, pi gets cancelled. Then I can write r1 square of delta theta 1, that's equals to r2 square of delta theta 2. Then I can write delta theta 1 divided by delta theta 2, that's equals to r2 by r1 whole square. R2 by R1 whole square means R2 by R1 by R2 equal 1 by 2 by 1 means then R2 by R1 equals to 1 by 2 square, then we can write 1 by 4. So then delta theta 1 upon delta theta equal to 1 by 4 I got. Now delta L1 by delta L2 means delta L1, that's equals to what can I write? L1 alpha 1 into delta theta 1 divided by delta L2 divided by L2 alpha 2 into delta theta. Okay. So lengths are same, L1 and L2. Coefficient of linear expansions are same. So then I can write delta L1 upon delta L2, that's equals to delta theta 1 divided by delta theta 2, we got 1 by 4. So the ratio will be 1:4. So simple problem here, okay, so they have given that materials are same means specific heats are same coefficient of linear expansions are same, densities are also same. These three quantities will depend upon the nature of the material. Both the rods are made up of the same material means all linear coefficient of expansions, densities, specific heats are same. So they have given that ratios R1 equal R1 by R2, radius of the ratio they have given 2:1. And lengths are also same, then what will be the elongation if the same amount of the heat is supplied. So same amount of the heat supplied means heat supplied to the first rod will be equal to the heat supplied to the second rod. So heat supplied, the supplied heat is utilized to raise the temperature of the rod. There is no change in state of the rod means then I can write M1 S1 delta theta equal to M2 S2 delta theta. This we have done in the last chapter. As the two material, two rods are made of same material means specific heats are same, then I can cancel this. Mass can be written as density into volume. Density into volume can be written as volume of the cylindrical column equals to area into length. So then I can write A1 into L1 delta theta 1. Okay. Similarly that, so then rho 1, rho 2 gets cancelled, L1, L2 gets cancelled. Then area can be written as area that's equals what can I write pi r square. So hence area means pi r1 square of delta theta 1 equal pi r2 square. Pi pi r else if you want, you can write this is also. Pi pi gets cancelled. Then delta theta 1, this is. So from the definition delta L1 equals to L1 alpha on delta theta by delta L2 equal L2 alpha to delta theta. Delta L1 by delta theta equals to 1 by 4. Like this we can now solve the problem number 16. Next to 17th, let us see. 17th. Okay, so length 17th after this. Completed? Emma. Students.
Yes, sir, at what temperature is the maximum density of water, sir?
4 degrees centigrade. At what temperature density will be maximum means 4 degrees centigrade. Minimum will be, volume will be minimum at that particular temperature. Okay. So, right, to see that question number 17. A rod of brass and that of iron differ by 5 cm length in all temperature. The length of the iron rod is, okay, the length of the iron rod is, for example, this is the rod. So, a brass, a rod of brass and that of iron differ by 1 will be more, we don't know. Rod of brass and that of iron differ by, let us take this is the L1 made of brass, okay. And this is the iron. This is so right, this is nothing but L2, this is of iron. What is the change in length means? That is nothing but 5 cm. For example, if this is length is L means then I can write this is L plus 4, correct? Length of the iron rod is taken L means length of the brass rod is L plus 5, and they told that what they have given, they told that the difference, this 5 centimeter will be constant for all change of temperature. When the difference will be constant, observe clearly when it will be means, the changing length of this iron rod will be equivalent to changing length of this brass rod. Okay, changing length of this brass rod. I think we have taken ulta. Generally, brass will expand more than iron. That's why iron rod length will be more than the brass. Which one will have greater alpha, brass or iron? They have given brass only. Brass will expand more. Brass will expand more.
Brass.
Let us take this is the they should they have to given that in the problem, but they need it. This is L minus alpha. So when it will be means, when it will be happened, so this is nothing but brass you can take, okay. So when it will be happened, the expansion of the iron is same as that of the expansion of the brass, so then only this length will be constant, understand? So they told that this change in length 5 centimeter is constant for all change of temperature means, for example, if this rod is expanded by 2 millimeter, and if this brass is also expanded by 2 millimeter, then what is the change in length? 5 centimeter. The length will be changed. The length 5 centimeter is more is constant. For example, if this is brass is expanded by 12 meter and iron is also expanded by 12 meter, then on such case also the difference of the length is always 5 centimeter. When it will be possible means when this iron rod and this brass rod will expand at the same manner, then only the difference of the length will be constant. So therefore, delta L of iron, that's equals to delta L of brass. So then I can write delta L means L alpha of iron into delta theta is equals to, so hence here it is L minus 5 initial length into alpha of brass into delta theta. These two are changes by same temperature raise, no? This delta theta gets cancelled. So then L into alpha of iron, 11
into 10 power minus
11 into 10 power minus 6 is equals to L minus 5 into
18
into 10 to the power of minus 6. This is gets cancelled. 11L is equals to 18L minus 18 into 5. This 11L taken this side and this is taken that side, then we will get 18L minus 11. 18L minus 11L means we can write 7L, that's equals to 18 into 5. Then L is equals to 18 into 5 divided by 7. That is about the value of L. Calculate the value, then you will get the answer. So understand this problem, the change in length is always other to the 5 centimeter means if the expansion in the iron rod and brass rod will be same, then only the difference of the length 5 centimeter will be equal. For example, if this is expanded more than brass means the change in length will be more than 5 centimeter. If the brass is expanded more than iron means the change in length will be less than 5 centimeter. So to have a change in length 5 centimeter constant, so then the expansion of the brass must be equal to the expansion of iron. The expansion of iron must be equal to the expansion of brass, that's why. And that too, both the rods are heated to the same temperature difference, so that's why cancelled delta theta. Here delta L means L alpha into delta theta. L stands for initial length. Initial length of the iron equals to L. Initial length of the brass is L minus 5. Calculated the type of answer. Got it? Students,
sir, brass will expand more, no sir?
That's why we have taken less length. Iron is expanded less, so that's why we have taken more, because change in length is proportional to the length, no? Got it? Okay. To have a change in length in brass, so we have considered the more iron length bar, more bar iron length, because the iron is expanded small, little when compared to the brass. That's why here more length compensate great change in length. Here alpha compensate the same change in length. That's the difference.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Got it, Tama? Next one. See that next one. So so 19th and 18th similar to that one. So let us see that. Let us see 20th question number 20. Question number 20, what they have given now. In order to have the difference of 25 centimeter lengths, okay, lengths at all temperature, the length of the iron and copper. So then what is the difference between that? So then I can write L1 minus L2, that's equals to 25 centimeter. Change in, I mean, the difference of the length must be equal at all temperature, that is nothing but 25. So they have given that one is made up of iron and one is made up of copper. When the difference of length will be constant means, as we have discussed, that if both the rods expanded equally, then only the change in length will be constant. If one of them expanded more than other, means the length will be, change in length is greater than this 25. If the one of them in will be mean second rod will be expanded more than the first rod, means the change in length will be less than 25 centimeter. It should not be happened, means first rod and second rod should have the same expansion. Then I can write delta L1 is equals to delta L2. Here L1 stands for iron, L2 stands for copper. Why only iron minus copper is 25? Why not copper minus iron equal to 25? Means observe that iron value of alpha is less than copper, means copper will expand more than iron. That's why to compensate with the copper, the length of the iron must be more than copper. Then only we can compensate the more expansion, equal expansion in iron and copper. Okay, so here more length will compensate expansion. Here alpha will compensate the same expansion in case compared with the iron. So therefore L1 stands for iron and L2 stands for copper. Then delta L1 means L1 alpha I into delta theta, that's equals to L2 alpha C into delta theta. This gets cancelled. Then I can write L1 by L2, that's equals to alpha C divided by alpha I. Alpha C stands for what? Coefficient of linear expansion of copper, that is 17 into 10 power minus 6 upon iron. 12 into 10 to the power of minus 6. This gets cancelled. So therefore we got L1 minus L2, that's equals to 25 centimeter, and L1 by L2 is equals to 17 by 12. So then how to calculate, eliminate L2 means then we can write L2, that's equals to 12 L1 by 17. So then L2 value substituted here, L1 minus 12 L1 by 17 is equals to 25. So therefore from this, if you take the LCM, then L1 of 17 minus 17 minus 12 divided by 17 is equals to 25. So then I can write here L1 is equals to 25 into 17 divided by I can write 17 5. Minus 5 means
5.
So then 5 1 so 5 5 is, so then L1 equals to 517. 85, no? Yes, this is 85 centimeter. Length of iron is 85 centimeter. Then L2 that's equals to L1 minus 25. So then L2 that's equals, we can write 85 minus 25 means 60 centimeter. So then length of the iron, that is nothing but 85 centimeter. Length of copper must be 60 centimeter. So students, understand why I have taken iron length minus copper length instead of copper length minus iron length. Understand, ma? Why you want to be length of iron minus length of copper is 25? Why can't be length of copper minus length of iron is 25? Understood that problem, this thing?
Yes, sir.
Got it, na? So here iron will be expanded less when compared to copper. That's why. To compensate the equal expansion with the copper means length of this iron rod must be more than length of the copper rod. The reason is that the change in length is proportional to length, initial length, no? That's why here alpha is less, no? To compensate that we have to consider the more length. Here anyway alpha is more, no? That's why E naught, that to compensate with the iron, the length of the copper must be less than iron. Based on that we can.
Yes. Sir, the ash code at 0 degrees Celsius. No?
Which one?
Sir, the ash code at 0 degrees temperature.
Ha, temperature difference is same, Nama. If 0 degrees means both are brought to 0 degrees, if 100 degrees means both are brought to 100 degrees. The change in temperature across the iron rod is equal to change in temperature of the copper rod. Temperature will be changed by same, no, same amount across both the rods. That's why we have cancelled this change in temperature. Got it?
Sir, if they asked to find the length of iron and copper at 50 degrees Celsius means?
That is also same, this is, it doesn't depend upon the temperature difference.
Sir, it will be same only, sir. 85 and 60.
Same only.
Sir, it can't be not, sir, it is expanding.
Which one? Which you feel that which one will be expanded?
Sir, both iron and copper.
That's what the movie do. Here it is. What is the temperature difference in iron if you go for 50 degrees?
Sir, initial we don't know, sir, to find difference.
Let it be initially there, for example, initially this is iron, okay? This is iron rod, this is brass rod or copper rod. Okay, initially they are at some 10 degrees centigrade. Now if the heat at 50 degrees means, what is the temperature difference of iron rod?
Sir, 40.
Similarly, copper?
40.
Same, now that's why they can cancel each other, temperature difference. When we are equating the change in lengths.
Sir, but now, sir, this lengths of iron and copper. Sir, that we are getting 85 and 60 now, sir.
Length is?
Sir, length of iron, that 85 and 60 we are getting now, sir. Iron and copper. Sir, that at 50 degrees Celsius, if the ash code means, what we have to do, sir?
Then you can, okay, fine. Right. Delta theta stands for what? Change in temperature only, no?
Yes, sir.
Length of iron into alpha of iron into theta 2 minus theta 1 of iron, that's equals to L2, and length of copper into alpha of copper into theta 2 minus theta 1 of copper. What is the theta 2 value and theta 1 value for iron? Say one value, initial temperature is what? Theta 1 equals to, as you told that?
10 degrees Celsius.
10 degrees Celsius. It is increased at 50.
50
degrees Celsius. Right? Both the rods are heated to the same temperature difference. No? Then I can write length of iron into alpha of iron equal to theta 2 for this iron rod is 15 minus 10. No? That is length of copper into alpha of copper into, again this is also 15 minus 10. Both are cancelling now there also.
Yes sir, yes sir.
That's why temperature difference is same. They are heated, if they heated separately means there may be a different change in temperature, there might be a different length. So, but here they are heated to the same temperature difference means this delta theta will be cancelled anyway.
Okay. But they asked that the length of iron and copper at 0 degrees Celsius. Sir, that my doubt is if length of iron and copper at 50 degrees Celsius if they ask means.
60 degree.
Sir, they give one in question. Length of iron and copper at 0 degree Celsius, they ask it, sir.
Hmm.
Sir, if they ask it, length of iron and copper at 50 degree Celsius means what we have to do, I ask.
At all temperature, this is the length will be that only. At all temperature, here it is 85 centimeter or else, okay. Right. Understand, okay. So,
sir. Thank you, sir.
At 0 degree centigrade, length of iron is equal to what they have given. Length of iron is equal to 85 centimeter. Alpha of iron we got is, what is an alpha of iron? 11 into 10 to the power of?
Minus 6
per degree centigrade. So, then what is the? 12. So, then length of iron at what temperature? 50 degree.
Yes sir, got sir, thank you.
So then length of iron is equal to how much means, can't I use this delta L2 equal to L1 plus 1 plus alpha into delta theta. If you know the length at 0 degree centigrade, by using this formula we can calculate the length of the iron and brass at temperatures that is.
Yes sir, thank you sir.
So, right, next question, see that next one. Okay, next question. 21 or 23, okay, 24, we'll discuss the remaining if right. So, 21, see that a steel tape gives the correct reading at 20 degrees centigrade. Okay, so here calibrated temperature theta 1 is equals to 20 degrees centigrade, which will give the correct reading at 20 degrees centigrade. It measures the length of a wooden log at 30 degrees centigrade. So, at the theta 2 is equal to 30 degrees centigrade. It measures the length of the wooden log. It measures means the reading of the scale that is equals to 10 meter. Then they are asking that what is the error in the measurement? What is an error in the measurement means if I know the true length, so then I can go for the error. So, what is the true length formula? Already we have it. Derived this true length L is equals to reading of 1 plus alpha scale into delta theta only. No? This delta theta is positive, the temperature is raised. Delta theta is negative, the temperature is dropped. So then true length L is equals to some reading R of 1 plus alpha value. They have given alpha. You know?
Yes, sir. 12 into 10 to the power minus 6.
12 into 10 power minus 6 into delta theta is nothing but 13 minus 20, then I can write 10. So, therefore, L is equal to reading is 10 meter into 1 plus 12 into 10 to the power of minus 5. So, then I can write L is equal to, so 10 into 1 plus 12 into 10 power minus 5 means I can write 0.00012 I can write. So then L is equals to 10 into 1.00012. So then meter. this is the true length, that is nothing but true length. So if you calculate the true length, means error is nothing but what? Error is nothing but error that is equals to, are you able to see, Amma? True length minus reading. That is called error. Reading is 10 meter, true length is equals to this. Then we can get this problem. Or else here also we can do that, this one. So from this one, what can I write? L is equals to R plus R alpha S into delta theta. If this is taken this side, then L minus R, that is equal to R alpha S into delta theta. What is this? L minus R stands for true length minus reading is nothing but error only. No? Okay. Error that is equals to R alpha S into delta theta. R is equals to what can I write? R is equals to 10 into alpha S is 12 into 10 to the power of minus 6 into delta theta means 10. So then I can write 12 into 10 to the power of minus 4. Then I can write 1.2 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Then we will get 1.2 millimeter. Okay. So like this we can do it, or else by using this also we can do. So students, already this problem we have derived earlier. Is there in your notes as? Hey, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, same problem we have used. By using this error in the sense true length minus reading. Reading is not accurate because the temperature has changed. You know, at 20 degrees centigrade, the reading will be accurate. But the temperature is changed, it means reading is different than true length. So the difference of the true length of the wooden log and reading made by the scale is nothing but error. That is nothing but true length L equal to this. There onwards we can do this or this, which you feel comfortable, you can copy that. Error that is equals to L minus R, that is equal to 1.2 millimeter. Okay. Got it, students, all of you?
Yes, sir.
So, right, so all 10 o'clock, this is enough today. So, that one or two problem, we'll see it tomorrow. What are the problems means, till up to 21, till up to 21, few problems we have done, no? So which are the problems we left for your practice, practice those questions. And if you did not get the, a question or anything else, you can ask us in tomorrow's class. We will discuss those questions. That is the homework today. So till up to 1 to 21 we have done now. So before the 21, how many questions we left? Practice those questions. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, students respond all. Okay or not?
Yes, sir.
Will you do it?
Yes, sir.
So, right, okay. So, practice that. If not getting, you can ask us tomorrow. So, see you on tomorrow's class.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
All right.